Brandon McCarthy of the British News, reporting from the great city of Manhattan, New York City, New York. June the 1st, apparently the Westchester coroner has confirmed now that 18, in fact, are dead. 18 bodies have been found at the tragic inferno of the graduation, national media has called it.
It seems as though... Oh, yeah, the bodies were found, and it was identified, dental records correlated, you know, the whole damn, you know, shiggy shebangle. I mean, turns out one of these kids, it was one of the girls, she was the daughter of a South Carolina senator.
I can't believe you showed up here.
Stop.
No, it's honestly disgusting.
June the 2nd here, the day after the tragedy, we have now discovered through MSNBC that the South Carolina senator, the incumbent of 3 terms Republican senator, actually has a daughter who is actually amongst the dead, tragically elevating this to a very...
Turns out that one of those, one of the kids that died, one of these kids, it was one of the girls, this is a daddy, she was the daughter of a South Carolina senator, actually. I'm afraid he is Republican, but sir, the thing you have to... It is too bad, but... He's a very powerful man. And he's getting some federal investigation involved.
One politician in one speech decided to get very personal.
You knew, you just felt it in your bones. Something bad happened. And I knew.
When he decided to tell his own story.
I don't know how I knew. But the call said, my daughter was dead.
And it became an emotional moment.
And I remember looking up and saying, God. As if I was talking to God, myself. You can't be good. How can you be good? Well, first time in my life I understood how someone could consciously decide to commit suicide. There will come a day when the thought of your son or daughter brings a smile to your lips before it brings a tear to your eye.
You are so stunning in that dress.
Of the last hours of the graduate.
I hope and I pray to keep your precious love. So before the night.
The way of the hurricane, and I think I'm fine. Like I'm in the eye of the hurricane. Yeah, he picks me up like he's got the way of the hurricane.
I'm looking at the front of it. The entire front of the mansion is on fire.
Mystery still surrounding a massive house fire.
Which makes many people wonder how it could have happened.
Total shock and awe that such a thing would happen.
Fire. Okay, how big is it?
With any kind of fire, an unfortunate incident like
this. It's huge. It's a huge fire.
It's a terrible tragedy.
The entire front of the mansion is on fire.
And it happened.
Ma'am, slow down.
Bad people can do bad things.
Ma'am, slow down.
And again, we have not determined whether or not there's any fault of anyone.
We have the fire department on the way.
It's just somebody did something wrong.
Especially the boy who survived. I mean, actually, there was 19 dead or something like that. But I'll tell you something right now. There's one kid that survived. And, you know, some people say you die of a broken heart. This boy lived because of a broken heart. And that's a whole other story altogether. Anyway, so he came in there as a key witness. Talked to the FBI. They suspected him at first, but this guy, you know, couldn't fly.
If you get a time, if you have time before dinner, Maybe you could hop on Google real quick and I mean, it's no big deal. Just, you know, if you get a chance. I mean, you know, don't stress out over it. And put in a search for a defense attorneys. Maybe OJ's people if they're still around. No, I'm not under arrest. Don't. I'm just the leading suspect. I didn't know about, why am I so like out of the loop about everything or anything? I've just been kind of in my own little world, you know. I've made a lot of new friends. I've kind of been kind of hanging with a new crowd, kind of like the popular crowd. I go to like wine tastings, you know, the horse races, art galleries, Broadway plays. I haven't you know, really spoken to anyone since the shindig.
Most of the cameras are the newest technology. There were some that were as small as a Tic Tac. Suffice it to say that there were very small cameras present throughout the home. I think that they caught the most of the pertinent events of that evening.
Why the cameras? Just the party. I mean, it wasn't.
Where the hell's my shirt?
I mean, it wasn't. Why the
lost their lives in a fire that happened at the conclusion of this party, and I say that with a solemn respect, and it breaks my heart to hear about this. These last hours have that much more meaning, and that's why I want you to take first.
Alright, he's bullshit. Who's next?
Yeah. Okay, you have to ask him. Even though you're a liar.
Truth or dare, Craig?
Truth.
Alright, Would you marry Angie?
Would I marry Angie? Why would I marry Angie? God, man, what kind of question is that? I think the real question you should be asking is what? Like, would she marry me? Like, you want to drink, buddy? Angie, you're beautiful. The last 4 years have been freaking the best 4 years of my life. Will you marry me? I think we could get married later if you're into that.
Are you serious right now?
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Yeah? Yeah? Fuck yeah! I kept the receipt, like, if you want to, like, return it. Like, if it doesn't fit.
Oh,
like,
okay.
If your fingers grow or something.
I don't think it actually.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's amazing. Can I see?
I mean, it wasn't. Why? Why the cameras?
That's so cool.
all. I do want to say that this was a long 4 years, and we went through all these courses and hard professors and extensive tests and everything that we did, but we did well. And I just want to say that once I graduate and after everything is done, that our degrees mean nothing because the economy is bad. So, therefore...
I agree.
Therefore, I'm going to go away and, you know, open schools.
Breaking news in the grad party saga. It looks like it was a murder-suicide.
He then placed fireworks throughout the residence, used an accelerant to assist in lighting the fire, lit the fire, and then shot himself.
First, put this guy with him on the fly. He was good people, this kid. And he had gotten shafted, he had gotten the wrong thing, but he's doing good now, and God bless him. But he represented kind of, you know, the last link between the fate of these kids that, you know, had grown on America. I mean, here we have three things happening.
It's a murder suicide. People are usually fairly disturbed.
Psychiatrist Walter Alford does a lot of work with serial killers and the mentally ill.
We have circumstances surrounding it becoming more and more disturbing and convenient. Like, you know, who's filming this shit and who's sending it to us and why they sending it to both the FBI as well as the studios, and who, you know, who's behind this thing? I mean, it became very kind of, a practical joke kind of thing.
Dr. Smithy, while an expert in these matters, speculates that the rock star may have been despondent over his declining career.
Owned it was like doing business with a fucking Swiss bank account.
This kind of thing, usually there's a screw loose pretty badly. It doesn't look like it on the outside, but when you scratch beneath the surface, you see there's something really crazy.
It didn't matter to me, because as long as I get my 10%, who the fuck, I don't give a fuck who made the damn thing, okay? If it was Fellini, Tarantino, or fucking Orson Welles coming back from the dead, it just don't make no difference to me.
Where a person, usually the male, rarely...
So, I make my deal, NBC does...
In 2012, a study reviewed 600 cases of murder-suicide...
Deal, NBC does their thing.
She says she's not surprised investigators are looking into possible financial issues as a motivation for the killing.
And then as we're airing this shit, and this thing's, you know, taking through the roof, and it's going to the point where they, you know, we want to renegotiate the deal to double the terms. But that, as that happens, new evidence is introduced, shall I say.
In all likelihood... the perpetrator may have really been hurting inside and believes that they're as miserable as he is.
And one of these dead kids all of a sudden turns up alive.
She describes perpetrators of this type as having mental health issues, the need for control, and a perception they cannot do what needs to be. The perpetrator doesn't think the way you and I think. They have black glasses on. They distort.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. This black girl who was a sassy girl in the film. I mean, she was always rubbing her butts up against people, but she...
Cohen points to data showing in a third of these cases, the perpetrator starts a fire to cover up their...
She sent a little letter, and she sent a little tape, a little outtake, if you will, of some footage that had not been broadcast or even shown to NBC, to my knowledge.
The way of saying... nobody's going to see the awful thing I did. They'll just see the ashes. Jacqueline Inglese, ABC Action News.
The kidnapping investigation.
But the footage was quite telling in what it did. After all that, a scandal ensued, and we were trying to figure out what the fuck was going on and who did what to where. Were they alive? Where were they? Who did this? What was the purpose? Was this true? Was this fake footage? Who knew?
The FBI is conducting a multi-state search.
We're involving all the logical field.
So finally, they sort of figure out that, yeah, they had actually filmed this, and they got the filmmaker in there. They actually found the filmmaker who had made this shit. You understand what I'm saying? They found him, they brought him in, and after bringing him in, they, you know, got some answers to some questions.
This is in this investigation to include... our headquarters. We're leveraging all available resources.
Now, sir, I can only imagine what you're going through. I've dealt with cases like this as a former prosecutor. That we have this chilling video to have your beautiful daughter missing like this. We have. What do you want to say, Al?
Just let my daughter go. Just let her go. She's a sweet young lady. She's not going to harm you or anybody else. So please, just let my daughter go.
Yeah. Because had these kids lived, who gives a shit about watching... 10,000 of these goddamn parties happen every day. Who gives a shit whether this was one was videotaped? Who gives a shit about these kids?
Have Have you been able to get any information about any possible motive?
I haven't got any answers. I would love more answers. But from the police department, I just need more answers.
Well, I'll tell you why America would care and did care. It's because they had died.
And I would love to ask a lot of questions.
What do you want to tell us about your daughter?
Or correct myself, because we thought they had died.
She's lovable, honest, hardworking, outgoing, will give anything off her back.
It's like, why are all these artists famous after they die? Something changes about the most ordinary things, or certainly the most extraordinary things change, but something about death changes a whole person's life.
But, you know, my main concern right now is just my daughter.
Don't make no sense to me, but...
And if she's watching right now, what do you want to say to your daughter?
I love you. We're doing everything we can to get you.
Just wait it.
Please, just let her go.
This way it's gotta be.